beautiful Libras. This is G1 Writer with G1 Insights, and this is your life and love energy for the month of July 2019, okay? So I'm not going to waste too much time. I'm just going to get right into it. July 2nd or July 3rd, give or take a day, the sun will still be in Cancer, right? So there's going to be a new moon happening here for us, okay? The new moon, of course, is a perfect time to really have like that fresh beginning, like that fresh start, right? But July is a bit deeper than that, spiritually, mentally, physically, and even emotionally, just because we literally just got past the past 6 months, right? And so this is just literally like the start of a new you, new day, new environment, new people. So you may consider moving this season, okay? Or you may have something new going on. I feel like there's going to be lots of resources for you, like, and that may even come to you about the second week of July, just because we are going to be dealing with that full moon energy in Capricorn that second week of July. So around the 16th, actually, not the second week, probably like the third week of July. That energy, that full moon energy, is going to be hanging around right before it even happens, right? So use all of the resources in the community, okay, or through people that you know, through family, through close friendships, through people that you just know. Use your resources to guide you this season, because I do feel like you are overcoming some anxiety or fear of something, okay? For a lot of you, this could even be old habits, possibly starting a new diet, possibly getting away from toxic energy. This is going to be the perfect time for you to start to surround yourself around people who really literally brighten you up, like literally uplift you, make you crack up so and make you laugh so hard, those type of people, right? The people that are real with you, that are honest with you, that won't BS you. That this is going to be the perfect season to really embrace all of that, just because again, with the new moon going into Cancer, being in Cancer, Mercury's also going to go retrograde by the end of that week. So about the 7th or 8th, give or take a day, Mercury is going to go retrograde in Cancer. But it's going to end in Leo. So this is a trickery. Oh my God, what is up with my words this season? Woo, all right. Let me start over. So this is going to be a tricky season, okay? Tricky Mercury retrograde, just because normally it goes retrograde in Virgo, but this time it doesn't. This time it's going retrograde in a sensitive sign like Cancer, and that is going to possibly stir up a lot of deep wounds, a lot of deep emotions, bringing up a lot of fear, a lot of nostalgia, making you feel extra sensitive. I mean, you're already a love bug, right? So bringing on some deep emotions like that can kind of really making you feel overwhelmed. So it's probably your best bet to really surround yourself around people who's not depressed. And it's not just saying, okay, because you're struggling with this or you're depressed or you're going through something that I can't be a friend or that I can't be around you. It's not saying that. What it's saying is that right now I have to cater to my deeper wounds and my deeper feelings and my emotions, okay? But however, that anxiety that you have or that attachment to old issues or old past life issues, anything, any old habits, I feel like you guys are releasing that. So this is good. This is perfect for you, because that means that you're ready for that new beginning. You're ready for that new home. You're ready for that new start. You're ready for that new relationship. And that's fine. Whatever you plan on doing, just make sure you do it before Mercury goes retrograde. Okay, this is extremely important. If you need to sign contracts, do it before Mercury go retrograde, because our clarity or our mind or the way we communicate is not the same when Mercury goes retrograde, because it deals a lot with our finances, it deals a lot with our communication, and your ruling planet will also go into Cancer sometime in July, okay? Around the 8th, actually. So just when Mercury goes retrograde, your ruling planet will also go into Cancer. So isn't that crazy? So you will be feeling a lot of the effects when it comes to your finances and when it comes to your home environment. All I would have to really tell you, Libra, is to just take it easy. Don't, you know, overdo it, and don't allow someone's energy to kind of overwhelm you or take you to that place of discontent, okay? Because I feel like a lot of you, not all of you anyway, because this is a general reading, but for some of you, a great deal of you are pretending. Not in a bad way, but you have this, you're really discontent about some things, not all things in your life, but some of you are discontent about a few things in your life as of right now, and that can change, like I said, by the third week of July, that can definitely change, but it's only going to change as if you embrace the changes that is happening. If you begin to embrace the changes, embrace the new you, the new lifestyle, the new environment, the new home, the new car, whatever it is, I feel like you guys are going through a period of transformation. So there's a lot of changes here, and so the universe just want to tell you that you do have a bright future ahead of you, and there's really nothing for you to really stress about. So just take it easy and try not to force things to happen. If something is telling you this is not working, then trust your instinct, okay? Because during Mercury retrograde, all kind of people are going to be coming up with ideas and ways to try to get money out of you or to try to get you to sign documents. Be very cautious about that. If you can wait to the beginning of August, all right, around the 8th to the 12th, if you can wait around that time, then you will have a lot more clarity, because by the 31st of July, Mercury will go direct. But of course, even after it goes direct, we're still going to be dealing with that shadow direct energy, okay? So just, again, as a precaution, if you can wait, try to wait until the second week of August, okay? So any trips or anything that you want to book, if you want to go somewhere, if you're thinking about traveling or moving somewhere, try to do it before Mercury retrograde. If it's not absolutely necessary that you have to go, like, right now, then don't do it. Okay, if it's not absolutely an emergency for you to travel like right now, then do not do it during Mercury retrograde. Just do it either before, sign the contracts before, or try your best to wait until the first week of August, so that way we can all have clarity. Okay, when Mercury is not retrograde, we can communicate better, we see things with a much more clear eye, we're not so objective, we're more receptive to things. So that is why I'm saying that, because your energy is going to be very, very sensitive in the first 2 weeks of July. You're going to be very sensitive and kind of still being emotional about some things. And you're not normally an emotional type of person, right? I mean, you can be kind of sensitive, but you like to have balance. You like when things are balanced and even out. You like equality. You like justice. You like when things make sense. You like logical reasoning. So when someone or an environment or a situation is making you feel tense or uncomfortable or is making you sad, you don't like it. You know, and it's like, so if you do happen to get that feeling or happen to come into an environment where there's a lot of tension, there's a lot of negativity, or there's a lot happening for you going on there, try your best to stay away from it, okay? But stop worrying, Libra, because everything is fine. You are blessed, okay? Stop worrying. Everything is going to be fine. I see that a lot here. Stop worrying. Stop worrying. It's okay. Stop worrying. That anxiety, it is gone, okay? You guys have to release that attachment, that thing that just trying to keep you stuck in bondage, you know, that fear of family or that fear of moving out on your own, going to college, you know, that type of feeling. That feeling of, I'm not sure if I want to put my money into this, or I'm not sure if I want to invest in that. Don't allow anyone, like, if you have a plan, stick to it. Okay, that's the energy this season. If you have a plan, stick to it. However, just be mindful, like literally read your contracts. Take your time and really look at every little thing. If you need to get a lawyer, get a lawyer, but make sure that everything is in place before you agree to it, because that is not the time to agree to any damn thing. I'll tell you that right now. You want to wait until at least the second week of August, okay? But the good thing is you do have resources. You do have a lot of love and support. You do have unlimited resources, so that is really, really good. If you have Virgo anywhere in your birth chart, I recommend that you look at their video, because it was very similar. I talked a lot about resources. So if you, or even if you have Capricorn in your birth chart, Yeah, take it easy, okay? Because it's, I'm telling you, this season is going to be a blessed season, but you have to be open, you know, and not allow your fears to overtake you, okay? So I love you, Libra. Have a wonderful week wherever you are in this beautiful universe. And I thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.